Hello everybody, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today our topic is nervous system. Nervous system means it is associated with neurons which is also called nerves. A bundle of neurons is called what? Nerves, which keeps us informed about the outside world. Whatever maybe we are seeing, we are listening, everything is stored in our brain. That's why once you will observe anything, if that particular thing is coming in your life again, then you can identify which substance is that, which person is your friend, who is your enemy, everything you can identify due to nervous system. Next one, but now you know that about several of the life processes that go on within our body without our even being answer for them. What keeps this process going on or coordinates? You know, actually, nervous system helps in coordination. Coordination and balance. Balancing. Coordination means one organ is coordinated with other organs. Means one organ depends on other organs for its function. That is called coordination, as well as body balancing. We can balance our body. Why? Due to nervous system. Again, another system also there, that is our one organ is there, ear. Our ear also helps in balancing the body, either static balance or dynamic balance. So in this chapter we will discuss about only nervous systems, how it helps in coordination as well as balancing the body organs. Understood? The nervous system is a network of specialized cell called nerve cell. Actually, nervous system consists of the structural and functional unit of nervous system is what? Nerves. It is a specialized cell of type of cell, which is the longest cell in our body. Longest cell in our body is which one? Nerve cell. And this carries messages away from the brain as well as towards the brain. Understood? Suppose a mosquito is sitting on your hand. Suddenly a message comes from the sense organ or skin to the brain that some mosquitoes, one mosquito is there. But then our brain is telling to another hand whether you will beat or you will remove or what keeps away the mosquito from your hand. How this process is going on? By the help of nervous system only. And nervous system helps in coordination also. One organ depends on other organ for its function. Understood? Next one. So nervous system is a network of specialized cell called nerve cell, or you can say neurons, that acts as a communication link between various parts of the body. Means it acts as a communication link between various parts of the body. How? From the brain or spinal cord, the nerves arises and it moves or leads to each and every part of the organ, up to foot, hands, brain, to each and every part of the organs. Actually, nervous system keeps us informed about the outside world. It controls and harmonizes all voluntary muscular activities, also voluntary and involuntary two activities. Later on we will discuss about that. Voluntary activities and involuntary activities. Understood? Voluntary means which is controlled by our brain, whereas involuntary means it cannot be controlled by our brain. Without our will, it functions. It has two major components. Which one? Our nervous system has two major components. One is CNS and another one is PNS. CNS means central nervous system. PNS means peripheral nervous system. Central nervous system and what? Peripheral nervous system. Central nervous system consists of brain and spinal cord. Central nervous system consists of what? Brain and spinal cord. And actually, it is the primary part of the control center. You know, primary control center, we can say this one. Which one? CNS. It is visible. Yes. Next one. It consists of the brain and spinal cord. The peripheral nervous system is a network of nerves. Actually, this peripheral nervous system. Periphery means outside. Peripheral nervous system leads to, or so many nerves are there which conduct electrical impulse to the CNS, or from CNS it takes message, it brings back what messages. Next one, let us learn more about neurons, nerves and nervous systems. We will read about neurons, nerves and nervous system. Neuron is the single one, single cell, you can say structural and functional unit of nervous system. Structural and functional unit of what? Nervous system is neuron. Whereas a bundle of neurons, it's called nerves, and another one, our nervous system is there, brain, spinal cord, about that also, about brain, about spinal cord also we will discuss. Clear? Next one, first we will read about neurons. Neurons like the structure is there. This is called dendrites. Singular is called dendron. Yes, so fluid-like structure is called cytoplasm. This is nucleus. This is axon. And this is terminal branches are there. Let's see. This whole part is called cytom. C-Y-T-O-N, cytom. Cytom name is also called soma. Soma is also called perikaryon. Soma is also called what? Perikaryon. Cytom also, soma also, perikaryon also, and another one cell body also we can see. Means cytom, this whole part is called what? Cytom, cell body, soma or perikaryon. Four names are there. Inside it, one jelly-like substance is there, cytoplasm. Again, here one small branches arises due to the extension of cytoplasm, that is called dendrites. And inside one central part is called nucleus, and a long processes is called axon. Is much clear? So neurons are the basic units of nervous system. Each neuron has a cell body, and inside that one nucleus is there. The cell body is called cytom, or you can say soma. It has finger-like projection called dendrons or dendrites, that is actually cytoplasmic extension. When cytoplasm elongates, then it forms a what? Dendrites or dendrons. The dendrites helps in catching the impulses, electrical impulses. Understood or not? Next one, the dendrites which have many branches helps to carry impulses. Impulse means the messages messages which is encoded with electrical signal. Electrical signal, why we are telling? Because very fast it is moving. That impulse is moving very fast. Understood? Next one. Another long tube-like projection is there, you can see. One tube-like projection is there. The tube-like projection is called what? You can say that is axon. Yes or no? Next one. Little bit. Another long tube-like projection called the axon extends outwards from the cyton and ends in many branches. The axon of some neurons have a covering. You know that here axon, some covering is there. That covering is called myelin sheath, actually sheath we can say, and myelin sheath also. And that myelin sheath does not allow the exchange of impulses. Myelin sheath, white color, white fatty substance is there, that is called myelin sheath, which do not allow the word exchange of impulses. Such neurons are called myelinated neurons. If this myelin sheath is there, no, then that is called myelinated neurons. That is called what? Myelinated neurons. Otherwise, non-myelinated neurons. If myelin sheath is not there, you can say non-myelinated neurons. If myelin sheath is there, then you can say myelinated neurons. Another one. Myelinated neurons conduct impulse. Inside impulse will move from not to the another dendrites or another neurons. In that case, if myelinated neurons is there, myelinated neurons, in that neuron, the impulse scale moves very fast as compared to non-myelinated or unmyelinated neurons. Understood now? In this case, the impulse will move very fast. Next one, an axon carry impulses away from the cyton. This axon carry impulses away from the cyton and the impulses move towards the cyton. Question will come. Impulses move towards that cyton, whereas it will move away from the cyton by the help of axon. By the help of what? Axon. Next one is what? An axon carry impulses away from the cyton and it branches, makes a connection with the dendrites of other neurons. What? I told you here so many branches are there, maybe visible or not. Yes, here so many what branches are there which leads to or attached with another neurons. Which leads with another neurons. Next one, forming a continuous pathway, thus an impulse can travel uninterruptedly from any part of the body, from the brain or spinal cord to each and every part of the body, and from the sense organ to brain or spinal cord by the help of that what axon and dendrites. They are, and dendrites are accepting the impulses, whereas dendrite axons are transmitting the what impulses. In this way, the impulse will move from one organs to another part, from one body part to another part. Next one, the junction between two neurons, that is called synapse. The junction between two neurons is called what? Synapse. One neurons meet at the other neurons at synapse. Understood or not? And they are exchanging again their what? The impulses, electrical impulse, they exchange in synapse also. Next one is what? The neurons that carry impulses to the brain and spinal cord. The neurons which carry impulses to brain or spinal cord, they are called which neuron? Sensory neuron. The neuron which carries the neuron which carries impulses to the brain or spinal cord, they are called sensory neuron, whereas the neurons which carry impulses from sense organs to the brain is sensory, whereas the neurons which carry messages from the brain spinal cord to other organs, they are called motor neurons. Which neurons? Motor neurons. Is much clear? Next one is what our nerves. Single one is called neurons and a bundle of neurons is called what? Next one is nerves. N-E-R-V-S. Nerves is a bundle of axons. When axons mix together and they are forming a bundle like structure, they are called what? Nerves. The neurons, or rather their cytone, from which the axon arises. From which the axon arises forms a bundle, and that bundle is called what? Nerves. Nerves can be of three types. Here also, sensory, motor, and mixed. Sensory, motor, and what? Mixed. Understood? Sensory nerves contain sensory neurons so that they can carry impulses from sense organ to the brain, whereas motor nerves contain motor neurons which carry messages from the central nervous system to what? All the other parts of the body. Next one, mixed nerves. Which one? Mixed nerves carry impulses or conduct impulses to and from the CNS, means to and from CNS, central nervous system. Either it will carry messages to the central nervous system or it will bring back the messages from central nervous system. Which one? Mixed. That's why its name is what? Mixed. Next one is our central nervous system. Which one? Central nervous system. Central nervous system consists of two parts, brain or spinal cord. Brain is the principal organ of our body, we can say also. It receives informations about the outside world, and according to that it behaves, or it coordinates other muscular activity, or it gives a message to or command to other muscular muscles to do what according to the informations which is coming from the surrounding. Understood this much? Next one, you know that this one we will discuss brain, we will discuss different parts of the brain are there, cerebrum, cerebellum, medulla oblongata, so many parts are there. But spinal cord, little let me tell you, later we will discuss more. Spinal cord, when some work has to be done very quickly, within no second, spinal cord is doing, because the message will move to brain, then it will give command. It will take some time, that's why spinal cord is doing quick responses. That is why spinal cord helps in reflex action. And what is reflex action also, I will tell about. The brain sort out all the information it receives and directs all our activities in accordance with that. It stores some of the information as a memory, because you know that due to memory only we can remind something, we can learn something, we can identify somebody. Understood or not? You can identify your friends in a what a crowd, in a what a fair or any crowded area, in that area you can find your friend by the help of your memory that is present in brain. you can take any decision. The spinal cord acts mostly according to the instruction given by the brain. Actually, the brain is giving instruction to the spinal cord, and according to that only spinal cord is doing work. Next one, the brain again divided into different parts. Before going to that, we have to know that the brain, what? Brain outside part, one part of bony structure is there, that is called cranium. Understood or not? And that cranium is also called skull. That is also called what? Skull. It is covered by membranes called meninges. The cranium is covered, the brain is covered with three layer membrane, that is called meninges. The outer part is called duramator, arachnoid and pyramidal. Duramator is the outer part, then arachnoid, then pyramidal. That is part of meninges. If that meninges inflamed, that disease is called meningitis. What? Meningitis. Three layer part is there, that is called meninges. Outer one duramator, middle one pyramidal, and the down one is what? Sorry, outer one dura, middle one arachnoid, down one, the last one is pyramidal. After that only your brain is there. So brain is protected by how many organs? You see, cranium, which is also skull. Above the cranium, muscles also there, hair also there. Then after that, three layer part is there, meninges. Then only brain is there. And in between them, one fluid is there, that is called cerebrospinal fluid. You can say CSF. Cerebrospinal fluid. Which also acts as a shock absorber of the brain. Next one, it also provides the neurons some protection from the infection. The brain has three parts, cerebrum, cerebellum and brainstem. The brainstem which connects medulla oblongata, pons and midbrain. We will discuss only cerebrum, cerebellum and medulla oblongata in this chapter. Understood or not? So, brain is divided into cerebrum, cerebellum and brainstem. Brainstem again, medulla oblongata, pons and midbrain. Understood? Today this much. Next class we will discuss about cerebellum, cerebrum and medulla oblongata. Reflex axon also, I will tell you what is that. How our spinal cord helps in reflex axon. Understood? Next.